that all it is? Is that all that matters, that we got done, that we made it through? I don't think so. Certainly, the Gospel of John does not think so. When I preached 3 weeks ago, I talked about context and how important context is. And context is important for us this morning as well. Because I would offer to you the idea that John sets the context for how we receive Jesus, our Savior. You have to remember now that John was written 50 years after Matthew and Luke. John's had 5 decades to ponder, to hear stories, to do theological reflection, to hear other ideas since the second and third Gospels were written. And so John gives us the big picture, right? Last Sunday we heard from Matthew. We heard about Joseph who was betrothed to Mary. We heard about Joseph who was not the father of Mary's child. We heard about Joseph to whom the angel said, "Be cool, it's okay, it's all going to work out." And we heard about Joseph who carried Mary and Jesus to Egypt so that they would be safe from her. And oh, by the way, Matthew says, Mary had the baby, it was a boy. And then Tuesday and Wednesday, we heard from Luke, the eloquent, amazing storyteller. We heard all the little wonderful details, and we forget that they're in one gospel and not 4 gospels. We heard about the arduous journey and why they had to make it. We heard about having to stay in a stable because there was no room for them anywhere else in town. We heard about a baby being born and placed in a manger full of hay. We heard about shepherds out in the middle of nowhere, because shepherds don't count to anybody. They didn't have to go be registered and taxed because they weren't that important. But that's the place the angel showed up to announce what had happened. It was the angels who got the news first. And then with those angels, there was a whole bunch more angels who were singing to God in heaven right in front of the shepherds. And the shepherds were so amazed that they went to see the baby and came back rejoicing. And Mary starts pondering. Wonderful story, great details, but now what? And maybe I should say, so what? What difference does that make today or tomorrow or Thursday week? Does it make a difference? Does it change how we carry ourselves out of this place today and go do something this week? Does it matter? Or are we just done with doing it again? I hope not. John says not. John sets the big picture. John gives us the context for this story. John says, way back before there was time and dirt and people and worms and whatever, there was God. And the Word was with God clear back there. And the Word participated in creation. Not one thing was created without the Word. Highly involved. And that Word was life. And that life was our light. And that light has always been, and darkness has never and will not ever overcome that light. That's important. Note that. That vast, enormous creativity, that vast creating Word of God, chose to be limited by our human finitude, to come and be with us, to come and be among us. Isn't that amazing? Isn't that just, it's another one of those things like Easter. I don't know how it happened, but I'm awful glad it did. to remember, to remind ourselves of our story, about a Savior, a God who loves us so much that he would come and take on those kinds of limitations in order to be with us. There's a lot of stuff in the middle of John about John the Baptist. John shows up in all four Gospels. He's an important figure, and obviously was important. They wouldn't have had to talk about him quite so much. And then John, the Gospeler, goes on to say to us, we have received grace upon grace. And I would add, upon grace, upon grace, upon grace. From God. A part of that grace is the presence of Jesus on this planet. We cannot, if we are honest with ourselves, we cannot say, well, God, you just wouldn't understand. Because guess what? God does. He was here. There's nothing that's happened to us. There's no reaction we've had that is unfamiliar to God. We are loved despite all of that. We are loved simply because God chooses to love us, has always chosen to love us, and continues to love us regardless of how we respond to God. We can walk away, but it will never be God who has moved. It will be us. John concludes this portion of his gospel by saying, grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God. It is God, the only Son, who is close to the Father's heart, who has made him known. Jesus walked this planet. Jesus modeled for us the way one loves God in relation to the planet and to the people on it. We cannot say we do not know what to do. We cannot say we do not know how to love as God loves. And of course we fall short. It's a given, because we're not Jesus, we're not God. But that doesn't make us any less called to try our very best to share that love, to discern what a loving response might be in a particular situation. So for me, that's why the story matters. That's why we do the celebrating. That's why we have special music and services on Tuesday and Wednesday instead of Sunday to Sunday. And I'll first, all day Friday, I was like, what do you mean it's the weekend? We just had church. No. We had extra church because it's important. So the final question is, how will you carry that story in your heart as you leave this place and head out into your week? How will you carry that love in which you are surrounded, through which you have the power to be loving, especially to those who don't deserve it? You know, just like us, who rarely earn our love, almost never. Occasionally, there's a blip. How will you do that this week? How will you be the love of God? How will you carry that light out of this place into all the other places who don't know about it yet, who need to know about it, but who don't, or maybe they've forgotten? That's why we celebrate Christmas. That's why we proclaim the incarnation. And it's time for us to claim our role in that as we move forward in forward into our lives day by day.